Hi friends, today we are discussing about deep ocean mission. So first thing, what is the significance of such a mission? It is actually a mission unveiled by the Ministry of Earth Sciences, Government of India. As you know, all the non-renewable resources which we are mining and exploring from the continents, from the land, is actually depleting. So our next prospective alternative towards these kind of mining spots and mines is deep ocean beds, where you will get almost all these minerals and hydrocarbon and petroleum. So India is going to explore this hitherto unexplored possibility of deep sea mining through a targeted, focused mission called Deep Ocean Mission. We have four key focus areas when we are planning such a mission. First thing is, as I said, it is deep sea mining. Second thing is Ocean Climate Change Advisory Services. As you know, the ocean and related areas, the climate of a region can be affected by the presence of an ocean. So the ocean climate is actually important, and climate change because of anthropogenic reasons can cause impact on humanity. So that area is studied in detail through Deep Ocean Mission. Third one is about underwater vehicles, which we are using for this exploration. Next one is underwater robotics. As you know, we can't make such mining just like what we are doing in land, because it should not be human intensive, rather it must be mechanized. So that possibilities of robotics is also a key focus area of this particular mission. And what are we focusing at? So what are the areas of Indian Ocean? We are focusing on Central Indian Ocean Basin. Why we are focusing on Central Indian Ocean Basin is because what we are searching for is PMN. PMN is polymetallic nodules, which is actually a predominantly manganese and iron nodule. It's a potato shaped polymetallic nodule, something like that of a potato or egg, which is present in the seabed. We are exploring for that, so that all our metallurgical requirements, all the ores, actually everything which is contained in our typical ores is available in this nodule itself. Say, for example, manganese is the biggest component, iron, then silicon, aluminium, nickel, copper, cobalt, then molybdenum, cadmium, all these metals are there in this particular compound. And in the whole ocean of the world, you can see it in four areas. First three are in Pacific. First one is Clarion Clipperton Zone. Third one is the Peruvian Basin. Next one is Penrhyn Basin. All the three are in Pacific Ocean. And Central Indian Ocean Basin is the fourth place where we have access. And the International Seabed Authority under the United Nations has granted us permission to explore around 150,000 square kilometers of our exclusive economic zone for this very project, where this is abundantly seen. So this is the target area of our mission. It is expected that if we are utilizing around 10% of what is available in the ocean bed, that will help us to deal with our energy requirements for the next 100 years. So that is the most important aspect of, or the significance of, this particular project. And there are something which you have to know about this, because there are certain problems also associated with this deep sea mining. That is loss of deep sea habitat. Just like what mining is doing to land, this will do to the ocean basin. And we have the first victim in the IUCN Red Data Book now, that is Scalyfoot snail. It is a species which is living in the underwater, undersea, deep sea habitats. And you know, the deep sea mining will pose particularly two threats. First thing, the sediments which is rising above with this ploughing of the seabed will be settle down in some areas along with the ocean current, which will cause the death of these kind of sensitive organisms, which is actually slow in their movement and which is staying to the near to the seabed. Next thing is, this plow can directly kill these kind of organisms like snails, sea cucumbers and worms, which is very slow in their movement, and this plow itself will kill them. So this has caused already an Indian Ocean species which is seen abundantly near the Madagascar regions called scaly foot snail, has already listed in IUCN Red Data book, and the habitat loss is the reason, and the habitat loss is caused because of this deep ocean mission. And most important, this scaly foot snail has a curious another name. It is also called as sea pangolin. So you may get these two terms, and it is an associated current affairs along with this Indian Ocean, this deep ocean mission. So you must focus on all these aspects while studying this. Thank you.